Good evening, everyone. How are you all? I hope that you are all doing well, even though in this very difficult and hard time, and you have to. Okay. So, guys, in last lectures, I remember that I started one medicine, Mephitis Putorius, but I could not complete it in a lecture. So, as a part of e-learning class, today I would like to complete this whole medicine. 2 to 3 days before, I tried to complete whole medicine in two part of the medicine, but it was too long, so I have decided that I will complete this medicine in 5 small part of the video, so it would be very easy to understand and download it. Okay, fine. So come to the, without wasting your time, just come to the point. First, name of the medicine, Mephitis Putorius. So first of all, you must understand what is Mephitis and what is Putorius. Okay, so here I would like to give one tip all of you, that whenever you or wherever you go to read anything, if you don't understand, if you stuck anywhere, so you must try to find out the meaning of that particular word, then go ahead. Okay, you must have to stop there and then go ahead. So that would be very good habit for the future, right? So here, the Mephitis, it is a noun. The word comes from Latin word mephiticus or mephitis. It means a noxious foul exhalation from the earth. Means noxious, foul, offensive odor. That is mephitis. Okay. Second, putorius. Putorius, the word, same word comes from again Latin word putridus. Putridus means decayed or rotten. Okay, so another meaning of this word putorius, putridus, right, means decayed or rotten. Its common name, I won't go in detail in certain area, right? You must have to understand its common name, Mephitis putorius, another name skunk secretion. I would like to spell over here skunk secretion, skunk, skunk, skunk. What is this? I will say you in detail later on, right? It's very interesting. Third common name, Mephitis mephitica. Okay, Mephitis mephitica. So now I would like to brief you about the some interesting matters of the medicine, right? First of all, I would like to say that if you accidentally combine two chemicals, ammonia and bleach, when you are cleaning your floor, and that combination makes mephitic cloud of gas, and that is not only horrible, offensive or smelly, but it is dangerous to inhale. It is dangerous to inhale. So this mephitic cloud has some connection with the medicine. That's why I'm saying, okay, this kind of mephitic cloud, because of some chemicals, okay, same kind of offensive odor or dangerous things will arise or arise with the liquid from which the medicine is prepared. Okay, so that's why just I would like to brief about this small matter about the chemicals, right? Now come to the point that this medicine had been proved by the German physician Constantine Jehering. I think you know very well, right? And generally, commonly we call him Constantine Herring or C. Herring, right? And here just I would like to brief you about his life history. He took his early education of medicine in University of the Leipzig. Then he moved to Pennsylvania, United States of America. And there he started his work for the homeopathy. And there also is disseminated. He spreaded the work of great homeopathic medical science in that country. During period of 1833 to 1880. And that's why, because of that great work, that's why in that country he is known as the one of the pioneer of homeopathy, and also he is known as the father of homeopathy in America, right? Also he proved the number of homeopathic medicine, and Mephitis is one of their those medicine. Literature saying he had proved about 72 homeopathic medicine, right? Okay. Also his 10 volume guiding symptoms and having slow of cure are very well known in the field of homeopathy. You know very well. Oh, that is also you know very well, right? So here just I would like to complete this video, and in next video I would say about the substance from which the medicine is prepared. Okay, thank you very much.